In this video, we are going over the bones of the hand. We're going to start at the proximal end and end at the distal end. So here at the proximal end, there's also going to be even a further breakdown of the bones in the palm. I'm sorry, pardon me, see the bones of the wrist. So we're going to have the proximal row and the distal row. So proximal is going to be the point of articulation. And this is, since this is in the wrist, this is the closest point of articulation to the ulna and radius. So the first bone we're going to go over is scaphoid, then lunate, then triquetrum, pisoform, hamate, and it has a little hook on it, which is a little easier to see. Then we're gonna have capitate, trapezoid, and trapezium. Next, we're gonna move up to the bones of the palm. And surprisingly, these are actually gonna be the bones in the palm. So a lot of people assume that these are gonna be a part of the actual fingers, but they are not. So we're gonna start with the first of the metacarpals, which is what these bones of the palm actually are. And we start at the thumb, and this is gonna be the first metacarpal, second metacarpal, third, fourth, and fifth. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're gonna next move to the phalanges, but first we're gonna talk about the thumb. So the thumb, and basically this is the part that you can see actually extending out from the palm. So the thumb is called pollex, and we know that it only has a proximal and distal tip. So if we move to the other phalanges, by the way, these also follow that same format of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The phalanges, again, is from the palm out. So we're gonna have the proximal phalange, the middle phalange, and the distal phalange. So if we wanted to talk about a number, to actually talk about a specific bone, we'd mention what number of bone it is and what portion of the phalange it is. So for instance, this would be the 1, 2, 3, 4th proximal phalange. And let's say we want to talk about this one. This would be the 1, 2, 3 distal phalange.